Good morning, students. So yesterday we studied about speed, scalar quantities and vector quantities. I also told you the difference between speed and velocity. Speed has magnitude only, size only, and velocity has magnitude as well as a direction. So any physical quantity which is defined by magnitude only is a scalar quantity. Any quantity which is defined by magnitude and direction both, it is a vector quantity. Now today we will compare another two physical quantities. Distance and displacement. Distance is a scalar quantity while displacement is a vector quantity. How do we differentiate between them? If we look in the first look, they look like same. What is the distance? Distance is the path covered by a body. While going from one point to another, whatever is the length of path, that is your distance. If I go from my home to school, the distance is 5 kilometers. Okay. Displacement is when you take a body from one point and displace it to another point, and whatever is the shortest distance that you covered is called displacement. So first point of difference is distance is total length, okay, but displacement is shortest length. How do we differentiate between two? I'll give you an example. In the first example, let a body is going from point A to point B. Okay, it is covering some distance. It is a straight path. So suppose the distance between A and B is 2 kilometers. Okay, now if I go from A to B, what will I say? I will say that I have covered 2 kilometers, a distance of 2 kilometers. But if I have to explain in the terms of displacement, then what is the displacement? It is the shortest length between initial point, that is your starting point, and final point, that is your ending point. So that shortest distance in this case is also 2 kilometers. So the point to be noted here is, in case of a straight line, in a straight line motion, the distance and displacements are same thing. There is no differentiation between them. But what if the motion is not in a straight line? Suppose the motion is in a circle. The body started from A. It is going like this, anti-clockwise, covering the entire path and coming back to A. So in this case, our initial and final point both are equal to A. We are coming back to the same point. Now what is the distance? The distance is the total path length. Total length of path. It is the total path length. Suppose the radius of this circle is 1 kilometer. Let it be the radius of the circle. So what is the path? The circumference of the circle. What is the circumference of circle? 2 pi r. So our distance covered will be equal to 2 pi r. But what is the displacement? Displacement is the shortest length between initial and final point. What is the initial point? A. What is the final point? A. So there is no distance, there is no path, there is no length between initial and final point. So in this case, displacement becomes equal to 0. I hope it is getting clear. In a straight line, distance and displacement does not have any differentiation. They are same things. But when the path is not straight, it is a circular path or any curved path, then the distance and displacement will have different values. The distance is the total path length, so 2 pi r. The displacement is 0 because initial and final positions are same. We'll take another example. This time, let A be the initial point and body is going like this. Then it turned and like this. This is the path. Let the distance between A and this point be 1 kilometer. Between this to this point be 1 kilometer. And between this to this point also 1 kilometer. Now, if we take distance, then the total length, the total distance will be 1 kilometer plus 1 kilometer plus 1 kilometer. That is 3 kilometers. What is the displacement? Displacement is the shortest length. how will you find the shortest length between initial point and final point? You connect them with a straight line like this. Okay, now whatever is the length between A and B, that will be your displacement. How will you find it? You can draw a perpendicular here and join it like this. Now this becomes a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. So if this is 1 kilometer, this will also be equal to 1 kilometer plus 1 kilometer. So it is a right triangle ABC in which the base is 2 kilometers. The height is equal to this. So 1 kilometer. Now by applying Pythagoras theorem, you can find the value of AB. Whatever is the value will be the value of displacement. Okay, so I hope the differentiation between distance and displacement is clear. Now, why are we putting displacement in a vector quantity? Next question is, why would we say that displacement is a vector quantity? Displacement becomes a vector quantity because when we are not moving in a straight line, when we are moving in a curved path or a random turning path, then it becomes very essential in which direction we are moving. If I am going towards north and suddenly move towards east, then my displacement changes. So direction becomes important when we are calculating displacement. Hence displacement is placed in the bracket of vector physical quantities and distance is in the bracket of scalar physical quantities. Okay. Now yesterday we compared speed and velocity. I gave you a formula of average speed, which is total distance upon total time. Similarly, the formula for average velocity is not like this. In average velocity, we have some initial velocity and some final velocity. Because velocity is a vector quantity, its direction will change. If the direction changes, its value will also change. So we do not take total displacement and total time. We take only final and initial velocity and find the average of them. So average velocity will be equal to initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. This is your average velocity. Having said that, what is the value of, what is the formula for velocity? The formula for speed is distance upon time. If we take corresponding values, then for if distance is vector scalar quantity, then what is its corresponding vector quantity? Displacement. Upon the time remains same. The time does not change. So velocity equals to displacement upon time. Speed equals to distance upon time. Velocity equals to displacement upon time. Now distance can never be equal to zero. If the body is moving, then distance will never be equal to zero. But displacement can be equal to zero. In case of circular path, displacement can be equal to zero. That means velocity can be zero even when the speed is not zero. So this is another point of differentiation between speed and velocity. So today we'll do this much only. Do the questions, do the solved examples and exercise question based on these topics. Send me your problems. Thank you.